जय गुरुदेव स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन द साइंस क्लास. चिल्ड्रन, यू नो वी हैव ऑलरेडी कंप्लीटेड आर चैप्टर नंबर 5 एंड नाउ टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट लेसन नंबर 6 विच इज़ फिजिकल एंड केमिकल चेंजेस. चिल्ड्रन, यू नो इन क्लास 6 ऑल्सो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट सम चेंजेस in which I explained you about the physical and chemical changes also. But here in this chapter we will study only about the physical and chemical changes in more detail. Okay, so let's see what they have given here. In the introductory part, this warm up, they have written that every day many changes are taking place around us. When you burn a piece of paper, it turns to ash. Ash cannot be changed back into paper. Look at each picture. Observe the changes occurring here, there. Can you change back the new substances to their original form? So, children, here some changes are given. You can see each of it that they are asking that when, whether these changes will happen, can you turn back these changes? Okay, so here you can see it shows something is broken with the help of hammer. Okay, and this is rusting of iron nail, and here it is a some tablet which is dissolving in this or going to dissolve. Now this one is cutting a piece of loaf of bread or something like that, and here they have shown stomach, part of stomach means here they have shown digestion of food. In our stomach always food is digested, and this picture also shows some kind of change means inside the oven or we can say microwave, any food is going to cooked. And this picture shows tearing of paper, or we can say by cutting they provide a shape to any paper or sheet. And here this is burning of candle, and this one is a kettle in which some hot object, hot tea or something is put and steam is coming out. So children, all of these are some kind of changes. So here all the changes when we do, you can observe that how many changes can you turn back or can be turned back their self. You can see here some of the changes are physical changes, means when we break anything with the help of hammer, then what will happen, anything can be changed into their pieces. Okay, and we can join those pieces, but we can't get original object. After joining also we can't get original object, understood? But here not anything new is formed, means any new object is not formed here. So it is coming under physical change, but this is not reversible. It is also irreversible because some of the particles can be broken as a powdered form, which we can't join again. And here this is a rusting. Rusting is a chemical change. Okay, this change we can't take back. Means that part which change into rust, that cannot be converted into iron again. Okay, and same in this case also, when anything dissolve in water or any tablet, here they have shown any tablet when dissolve in water, it is impossible to make the tablet again after any process. So this is also a kind of chemical change, because when we dissolve any tablet in water, its chemicals are totally changed. Okay, and this is an example of physical change. Here also no new object is formed, but once we cut the piece of any cake or we can say loaf of bread, we can't join again. It is a physical change but irreversible change. And this is a chemical change, because once food is digested, at that time we can't take back the another, we can't turn that food into its previous condition. And here also, when food is cooked, then that change cannot be turned back. And this one is also, here no new substance is formed. This is a physical change, but we can't join that paper pieces as its original shape, or we can say how it was looking previously. So this is a physical change but irreversible. And this burning of candle is also a kind of physical change as well as chemical change. Because when wax is melting, that is called physical change, and some of the wax vapors and this wick also, the thread which is present at the center of the candle, when that will burn, it will not be turned back again. Understood? So here both the changes we can study in this case. And here also, if it is water, water changes into steam, and this steam can be collected back to again make water. So this is a kind of physical change. Only state of the substance is change here. So children, some of the changes we can say, we can conclude from this part, that some of the changes can turn back, but many of the changes are like that also, which can't be turned back in their original forms. Understood? So you can also see so many changes around you and in your daily life, that some of the changes, once they happen, they will not be changing into their original form. Now next is a physical changes. So under physical changes, they have given every substance has its own set of physical properties. Characteristics of a substance that we can observe directly, such as color, size, texture, state, are called its physical properties. In a physical change, physical properties of a substance may change while its chemical composition remains the same. For example, while melting off, its state changes from solid to liquid, but chemical composition remains the same. So physical changes do not produce new substances. This sentence, children, you keep it in your mind, and always you remember this thing when we talk about the physical changes, that physical changes are those changes in which no new substances formed or produced. Okay, those changes are called as physical changes in which no new substance is formed. If any new substance is formed in any change, then it is coming under the chemical change. Understood? So here in this paragraph, what they have written, that every object has some physical properties, like its color. Here they have given list of physical properties: color, size, texture, state. These are the physical properties. If these changes will happen and their internal chemical structure remain the same, then we can say it is a physical change. Okay, means their chemical composition remain the same, that will not change, then the change is called physical change. And no new substance is formed. This is the main condition of physical change. Many physical changes can be reversed using simple physical methods. For example, molten iron can be cooled and turned back into its solid form. Now, many of the changes are the physical changes also. Here they have given a best example, that if we melt iron, okay, by heating, if we melt iron by heating, then what will happen? If we cool down again, and at that time, after cooling, they again, that iron again converted into its solid form, but no new substance is formed here. Okay, we can make so many tools of iron by this molten method, or by heating. But in this case, no new substance is formed. Means the main material remains iron. After heating also, that iron remains the iron only. Understood? So that's why this is called a physical change, because in this case only iron melts. It will not change into any other substance. So some examples are changing states substances. For example, ice, which is a solid, upon being heated, changing to water, which is a liquid, and water turning into steam, tearing of paper, dissolving sugar in water, crumpling paper, chopping of wood. So children, these all are the physical changes, because in all these changes no new substance is formed. Means if we tear paper, that after tearing also it remains the paper only. Okay, no new substance is formed here. And when we heat water, it will change into, means if we heat ice, it will change into water, and if we heat water, then water will change into steam. But these are the states of water. Water remains again water when we decrease or increase heat. Okay, so this is also physical change. And here dissolving sugar in water also, it is a physical change, because after dissolving sugar in water, when we again heat this water, water will evaporate. In this way, means water will change into steam, and slowly full water will evaporate and leave the sugar behind. We again get sugar here. And crumpling of paper means if you crush the paper, then after crushing also, After folding also, paper remain the paper. And chopping of wood, if we chop wood, that time also, the pieces of wood remain wood only. No new substance is formed. So that's why these all the changes are coming under the physical changes. Okay, children? So here they have shown some activity. These whatever activities are given in your chapter, that I'll make a video of these activities and I'll show you. I'll post someday after the completion of chapter, or sometime when we complete the syllabus, then that time we will do these activities. This is a simple activity to show that boiling of water is reversible physical change. Means this activity is a very simple one, you can do at home also. Means you take out ice from refrigerator, and for some time when you keep in room at room temperature, means keep in your room, you can see that slowly slowly ice will change into water. So that is a kind of change also. But in this activity, they are showing the boiling of water. You can see, children, when you boil water and you cover with some lid, and you can see that water vapors, after boiling, they stick to your lid, and when that water vapors cool down, they will again change into water vapors, means water, water drops. So that time we can say that this is a kind of physical change, because no new substance is formed, and it is a reversible change also, because once a change will happen, that will turn again into its original form. Understood? So this is a kind of activity. So children, next is a chemical change. Chemical changes occur when two or more substances, or we can say reactants, react with each other to form new substances or products, we can say. You have studied about the chemical changes or chemical equation also. You can see that those substances which react with each other, they are called reactants, and after arrow when we write equation, then after arrow we will write the product. Okay, so when any two substances, two or more we can say substances, they react with each other, they are called reactants, and after reaction they will form new substances which are called products. At that time we can say chemical change takes place. Okay, so in a chemical change, the properties of the products are different from those of the reactants, because here the bonds between molecules or atoms are broken or formed to produce new materials. Most chemical changes are irreversible. So children, in this paragraph what they have written, that in any of the chemical change, what will happen, why it will not be turned back to its original form, because whenever chemical change happens, at that time the bonds which are present between the molecules or atoms, you know, everything is made up of molecules or atoms, so there is some bond present between them in which they are joined with each other. So whenever this bond will be broken down, at that time what will happen, their chemical structure totally becomes changed. Okay, so because of the change of chemical structure, these means most of the chemical changes are irreversible, means they cannot be turned to its original form. So here they have given example. For example, we cannot unbake a cake means once a cake we bake the cake, we cannot turn that change or we cannot unbake a cake. Means the material which once formed, we can't change into its raw material. Okay, so food once digested into a living body cannot be brought back to its original form. Okay, so any change when happen, that change cannot be turned to its original form. Once the food is digested, that cannot be changed into previous condition or previous state. So also once milk turned into curd, we cannot change the curd back into milk. This also children you know very well, that once we make paneer or once we make curd from milk, we cannot change that product into milk, because their chemical structure, their inner chemical bonding now becomes changed. Okay, so that's why it is called a chemical change. So we experience chemical changes in things around us every day. Cooking of food, rusting of iron, souring of milk and burning of fuel are a few examples of chemical changes. So children, few chemical changes they have given here, that cooking of food, rusting of iron, souring of milk means to make curd from milk, this is called souring of milk, and burning of fuel. These all are the examples of chemical changes, and these all are the irreversible changes, means they can't turn back to its original form. However, not all chemical changes are impossible to reverse. Under sufficient pressure, carbon dioxide dissolves in water, but when the pressure decreases, carbon dioxide is released in the air again. So this is also a kind of chemical change, but it is a best example to study the chemical change but reversible change, because once carbon dioxide gas, once it dissolved in water, at that time again when pressure decreases, or we can say temperature decreases, at that time carbon dioxide again can be released in the air. Okay, so some of the examples are like this also, then that some new substances can be formed, but they are reversible also. Understood? So children, up to here what I have taught, you try to read yourself and try to understand. And if you not understand anything or if you have some problem, we will discuss in the next class. Okay, so Jai Gurudev to all of you.